Hey guys, this is Aaron. I have a cabin right here, a little log cabin I built, and I want a way to visualize this in a little more realistic setting without having to use a third-party renderer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at some options with my styles, specifically with watermarks. So here in my styles window, I'm going to click on the second to last tab, which is watermarks. Once I'm in here, I'm going to hit plus to add a new watermark. Watermark's going to let me choose any image file I want. So I have this meadow image. I'm going to go ahead and pick on that and click open. And it's going to show me, it's going to start by calling it watermark one. I'm going to call it my meadow. And I'm going to say I want it as a background. I'm going to click next. And I have the option here of selecting how much I want that to bleed through. I actually want 100%. I want that image just as bright and shiny as it is by itself. I'm gonna hit on next. And I have some options of where I wanna place it. So stretch to fit the entire window is where it's at now. Tiled, obviously, is not gonna work for me very well. Positioned in the window is what I'm actually gonna shoot for, because I want this to fill the entire screen. So I'm gonna put it there, choose my anchor point, which is the center, and I'm gonna slide the scale all the way up. So it's gonna fill my screen left to right. And hit finish. All right, so now my cabin is floating around inside that image. So as I orbit or pan, move around, I'm actually moving it like it's in the image. So I'm gonna put this back here. Where would it look good? That looks about right, maybe right there. So now what I can do, it looks okay. This looks pretty good. This is a good start, but I wanna make it look a little more realistic. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a little more work with my style. I'm going to come here to lines and I'm going to turn edges off. So now, getting a little closer in real life, I don't have edges on things, getting there, looks pretty good. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on shadows. So here's my shadow window. I'm going to go ahead and click on the shadow icon. And this doesn't look like much to start out with. I'm going to have to do a little bit of fine tuning. One thing I want to do is the shadows here on the left side, but I can see my shadows on everything over here kind of falling to the right. So I'm gonna mess with my daytime till I get it to kind of come over to the right a little bit more. There we go, that looks like it's a little closer. The other thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change my light and dark. What I've found from experimenting is if I turn my light just about all the way up, or maybe all the way up, and turn my dark down, I get a little more realistic render or shadow like that, as far as my lights and darks are concerned. So I'm gonna turn that a little bit more, maybe push it back a little, and I can make it look like it's actually sitting in that drawing. So that's about it. Pretty simple. Easy way to get a semi-realistic image out of SketchUp using just styles and watermarks. Thank you.